Sewmakers. I'm Katherine Harris with Sheer Stitchery, and this is your spot for all things sewing and DIY. So hit that subscribe button down below. This week, I wanted to share my thoughts on the Charm Patterns picnic top. We'll get to that in a moment. So let's get to it.
Let it go, what's the use in holding on? Can we find a way where we could spend some time alone? You know where to find me, you know which way to go. As long as you love me, we'll be singing all night long. So take a minute to hold me, I want nothing more than your arms and to be your baby tonight.
So the picnic top is a Patreon pattern that goes with the free picnic skirt from Charm Patterns by Gretchen Hirsch. Now, I absolutely love all of the Charm patterns, and they usually fit me right out of the box absolutely perfectly, so I did not do up a muslin for this top. That being said, with this particular top, I did find it to be a little big. Now, I do like the fact that it is nice and roomy along the sides because it gives a nice vibe to that cropped version. And I did do the cropped version. They have a full-length version if you want a little bit more coverage. But I really like to wear a nice high-waisted skirt or pair of pants with these. And you can see these sleeves keep kind of like falling down, like almost completely. So what I am finding is I am going to need to do an adjustment on this the next time that I make it in order for it not to continue to slip down. So I'm just going to shorten this. So if I look in, I have about this much. So we're looking at almost about 2 inches that I need to reduce on this. And I would just take that out probably up at the, not the shoulder seam, up at the front here. Because if I take it out of the shoulder seam, I'm going to affect my range of motion with my arm. So I'm just going to go in and take that out. But for the purposes of this particular blouse, I still want to be able to wear it. So what I think I'm going to show you is how I take it in the back after you have already made a garment and it's just a little too big. So let's get to it. So to start, I have pinned it when I was wearing it, and I actually pinned it in the back because that's where I want the dart to be. And I'm just marking both ends of the dart here with a water-soluble marker. And now I am going to go in and actually measure to make sure that they are the same width. And I have calculated that they are the same width here, and I am just adding in, and I actually decided to do 2.5 inches is what I needed to take out right here. And this part here where I am actually measuring out where I want the leg of the dart, I actually do change this later on, so you won't need to do this step right here, but I thought I would show it just so you can kind of see where my thought process originally was. I wanted it to go out kind of along to where the arm side is. But then as I match the two darts together, it's actually forming a nice dart here anyways. So I am just matching those two tips here. And then what I'm going to do is I am just going to come out and have the tip of the dart end just above where we have the sleeve here. So I was just making sure that that is nice and even along the sleeve cap. Now we don't want to put our dart into that seam along the sleeve cap. So we want to have it end just slightly before that point. And then I am getting out my ruler and I am just going to connect this. And then I'm going to do the exact same thing to the other side, matching up both ends of the dart here with right sides together. I am working from the lining side. And then I am going to match this up, and rather than putting a dot, I'm just going to eyeball it here. And then we're going to stitch our darts as you usually would, and it looks just like this. Now, it is not the prettiest thing. That being said, it is a way to salvage a garment that is much too big for you so that it still fits nicely and you do get some nice wear out of that. So I'm just ironing this towards the back of the garment, and you can see that it looks just like this from the back, almost like there is a seam going all across the top. That feels so much better. So it is no longer slipping off my shoulders, and I have saved this shirt from finding a life of never being worn in my closet because it didn't fit right. Which is a lesson to say, do up a muslin, it's probably best practice. I don't always do it. In this case, I probably should have. Now, I had my husband pin me off camera. He is a little camera shy, so he didn't want to do that on camera for you, but how I had pinched it in the front, we just did that exact same thing in the back. And now that I have it in, it is completely seamless. Well, you can see the seam, but it looks like it was intentional. So I really like how I saved this. Now by doing this, it does make the crop just a wee bit shorter. So what you're going to want to do if you are adjusting your pattern is you're going to want to take out the same amount. So if you're taking out the 2.5 inches, you're going to half that, so 0.75 or 3/4 of an inch on the front and 3/4 of an inch on the back pattern piece. And then you are going to add that same 3/4 of an inch along the bottom hem so that you can get the same hemline. In fact, I kind of like it where it's just a little bit more cropped because I got a little bit of skin peeking through when I wear my high-waisted skirts. So I think that that looks really cute as well. Don't forget to make those pattern adjustments on your pattern so that you don't make it again thinking that it fits perfectly. So do be sure to do those right away or make notes somewhere. And now I wanted to share with you a really quick process on how I whip this up. I'm not going to show you exactly how because Gertie has a fantastic tutorial for that, but I thought you might enjoy my sewing process. Let's get to it.
Let it go, what's the use in holding on? Can we find a way where we could spend some time alone? You know where to find me, you know which way to go. As long as you love me, we'll be singing all night long. So take a minute to hold me, I want nothing more than your arms and to be your baby
tonight. So much for joining me today on this journey of making this picnic skirt and some impromptu alterations that we did to fix this top so that it now fits. If you enjoyed this video, do give it a big thumbs up. And until next time, makers, let's get our sewspiration on.